Hey my friends, welcome back. Yeah, as you can see, we go big today. We're gonna do this big landscape slash seascape painting here. So we grab a set of 7 colors, as you can see on the left side. Mixing the colors for the background, more or less, for the first layer, for the clouds. Yeah, establishing the rough location first, for those cloud bodies, more or less. And you see it's very flat. Very flat actually, but in this stage you basically just take care about the rough location where we have the cloud bodies themselves. Intermix colors here and there. You mix the color on the palette, but it's not like kind of chiseled off in stone. It's more or less like you have to adjust the colors back and forth to really get them in. Yeah, if you like to see the full-time version of this video here, make sure you check out my Patreon, link down below here. Yeah, after this little commercial break, we continue to build up the underpainting. And I made a cut and it's kind of boring to watch. And set of brushes that we're gonna use for the now second layer. The painting is now drying completely. I let it cure for a couple of days. And then I start to build up the cloud details. The key point here for you is to really understand and watch me grabbing the amount of color that I'm using, or to really judge the amount of color that I'm using here. I'm basically grabbing a fresh amount of color and start to build up those cloud details here. And when the color on the brush basically starts to fade away, I extend the cloud outwards. This is something that is very important when it comes to painting clouds. You want to have the cloud not like cut out. I said this before in other videos, but it's really one of the major points when it comes to painting clouds that I see a ton of people doing clouds that look not bad, but they paint them like I do here now. You see, the left edge basically is at the moment not yet blended enough, kind of, especially on a very large painting like this one here. You really want to have those very fine connections with the background color. And you see here, I did some blending to it. And it kind of fades out, it kind of melts to the background color. This is, I think, the first and, not the most important lesson, but the first lesson for you here to take away and to really get a feeling for how it needs to look on a smaller scale when you zoom in, that the clouds really appear to look realistic when you zoom out, more or less. And this is very important for those bigger paintings. When you step away, those clouds really, if they are not fading out, if they are really too blocky, if they are really too edgy, they really start to fall off the painting, if you know what I mean. I'm building up on the dry layer of color, a very blended area of the clouds here. We have clouds kind of emerging from the back. And this is done again by the dry brush technique. I'm grabbing some fresh color and connecting the dry color that we have on already with the blue color in the back, and the color also of the cloud body that we have in the front. I'm constantly readjusting, adding a little more kind of a layer of color. I mean, I would say it's kind of a thick glaze, or it's difficult to, where do you make the difference, or where do you make the cut? Is it a glaze, or is it just a bit of dry brushing here and there, what I'm doing here now? I mean, basically, the point is that you Yeah, when you want to build up a cloud body like this, you again have to really be careful about the amount of color that you take on your brush. And yeah, this way of building up the clouds make it really just a lot easier than trying to get this in the first go. I mean, some people apparently are able to match the colors, not only right, but also the blending of the colors and the overall shape of the cloud. And yeah, I truly admire those people, but I think it's easier, especially as a newbie painter, to really try to, kind of slowly progress building up those clouds. I mean, it's just two layers that I'm doing here, more or less. Okay, I'm sometimes reworking areas again, adding some more color to the already existing colors that are still wet sometimes. But the majority of the work is done with the first layer, and then the detail second layer. Oh yeah, not really final detail stage layer, but yeah, kind of a fleshing out the whole thing, making it more 3D. Yeah, this is something that I'm obsessed with, the painting surface. I don't like to see those structures from the canvas. Therefore, when I have the color on very thin, I grab a very stiff brush here. So I think that's a synthetic one. And this is ideal for fine blending those areas that, I mean, you don't have to do it like me, of course not, but when you are just like me, obsessed with the surface, you have it easier when you grab this very stiff brush and go left, right, up and down to really hide the structure of the canvas. Yeah, and here now, you see me basically adding the final details here on the still wet second layer. I mean, you can put it in while the color is still wet from the second layer, but you can also put it in when it's completely dry. And just building up some more cloud details, some more parts where we have some more steps, some more detail areas here and there. And again, I'm grabbing a small brush, a very soft one, and blend the whole thing so that we have again this very softness, this very soft appearance of the cloud. That is another key. I mean, we had this key before, the extension, the melting of the cloud into the background, but in the cloud body itself, it also needs to be very soft. I mean, it will become more solid when you step more away from painting. Therefore, it's really important to do it, especially on a larger scale, to get a certain softness in. Yeah, here, I'm building up now, kind of fleshing out, working out the 3D effect on this cloud here again. This cloud, or this part of the cloud, is not as 3D as the other parts. It's a bit more boring to watch, or a bit more boring to see, but I try to follow the photo reference, and some clouds need to be there to build up the contrast between those very 3D looking parts that you have in your cloud painting and other areas where we have just hinted or some clouds that really don't stand out that much, that don't have this volume appearing to them, more or less. I think it's, you don't have to do it on every painting, of course, but when you try to follow the reference that I use here, then you should do it this way. I'm kind of again fleshing out the the sunlit area on this left cloud body here. And yeah, the very nice thing about this way of painting is that you don't have to care that much about mixing all the colors beforehand, and not having like 15 brushes on your left hand when you are a right-hander to constantly change the brush that you should do when you try to keep your colors clean. In this case, I basically just add the lighter color on top of the first layer that we put in. And with this kind of easy trick, you build up details and more volume in a very, very easy way. And now I'm building up the dark areas. Again, kind of a dry brush blending. You also see me grabbing bigger, harder brushes. The one that I've used before, this white one here. And this is very good tool to kind of get the color in in a very blended way on this canvas structure. It's not that easy to dry brush blend on a canvas. When you have a very soft brush, you need to go over the whole thing 15 times. And with this a bit stiffer brush, you save quite a lot of time to kind of dry brush and build up the volume in those shadow areas in a very easy way. And again, the amount of color, the amount of color control, so to say. I don't know the correct English word for this, but it's very important, especially here now. You see, I'm just adding a little hint of color. Then I grab a softer brush and shape out the darker area of this cloud body here. This kind of requires a lot of practice because some beginners tend to use too much color. And when I use, or the other way around, when I'm building up those second and third layers, I don't grab that much color. I really use just hints of it and then just rework those areas that need some more definition, some more depth, some more lighter areas, some more volume, whatever. And this is something that you need to build the experience with. Don't get frustrated when it comes to painting clouds, when you don't have a clue, or when you don't have that much experience. It really it's a craftsmanship that you can learn when you take the time. But it takes, I don't know, a few dozen paintings that you are not really satisfied with when you start to learn how to paint, especially clouds. I mean, all topics basically, but I think clouds, are very, very difficult to paint. Yeah, now we are done, more or less. So that's about it for the first part of the video. Next week we're gonna do the lower end of this painting here. The beach and the sea. Thanks for watching. See you next week. Bye.